First of all, thank you very much for having me here. I think it's been a really interesting panel so far, and I think there are a lot of common themes, which is great. And I decided to take the approach of talking a little bit more about what's new in online publishing, more from a kind of a process and tools perspective. So considering the audience of production folks, I'm going to kind of go from the macro down to a little bit of the day-to-day stuff. But first of all, I'm from Silverchair, and we launched our SCM6 platform earlier this year. And these are some of the clients that we're working with. We have JBJS and American Psychiatric Publishing Live, and you'll start to see us releasing sites with the rest of these folks later this year and next. So I joined Silverchair in May, and as the chief product strategist, which is just a really cool title, first of all. what it means is that I get to work with our publishers basically as their advocate to figure out how they're going to implement their websites, what technology they need, what their processes are going to be. And so therefore, my focus here is really thinking up from the publisher's point of view. So what I've learned in the last 7 months or so from the different folks that we've been working with, of kind of what's making a difference, what's new in online publishing, are tools and processes. So first, the tools aspect are semantics with a purpose. We've heard a lot about semantics and taxonomy, so I won't dwell too much on that. Multi-format content integration. Making a portfolio come together in a way that's user-centric as opposed to product-centric. Automation of kind of the back end, the process, making the tools to upload and tag content easy for the folks who are running the content operations at the publisher or at the vendors. And also a new, I think, approach to integrated user interface design. And then I'm going to talk a little bit at the end about the process of product development and finding, as we've seen, things are moving very quickly, business models are changing, users are expecting different things. What we are hearing from our publishers is they want to be able to quickly develop their products over time, but do it in an evidence-based way. So getting away from the two-year planning and speccing cycle to how can we, once we're live and up and running, learn from what is actually happening on our sites, and then innovate from there. So the first is semantics with a purpose. Again, I won't spend too much time on this because we've heard a lot about semantics today, but basically two types of readers, people and computers, and semantics are about meaning and adding a layer of meaning to content so that you can answer the questions of what is this content about so that computers can serve it up for folks. We've heard there are all sorts of different semantic technologies out there from very lightweight controlled vocabularies all the way to RDF triples. At Silverchair, we use a combination of different things. So what do they do? They provide a normalized, logical metadata layer to your content. And they're also used to classify and reveal different elements of the content. Basically, breaking down to small bits, content atomization, and then you can start to do stuff with it. So here's an example of what you can do with when you've got the semantic layer baked in. Here's an article in the American Journal of Psychiatry, based on the semantics of semantic fingerprinting of this article, we're able to quickly and dynamically surface related content from other articles, from books, from topic collections, from news, and then from external sources like PubMed or guidelines, clearinghouses, or even jobs and other things. We also see the results through search, where we've talked about equivalence in the semantic layer. And so therefore, if you put in a search on AJP for manic depression, it's an outdated term, people don't use that anymore. Search engine knows to go and retrieve content that matches bipolar and other equivalents from across the content store. So basically, as you tag and apply the semantic layer, you're able to kind of extract content across your collection in ways that are going to be more meaningful for the users. Which leads into my next point that we're hearing from publishers, that they're really looking at their portfolios as a content collection and as an asset. And instead of trying to just individually grow products on their own, they're looking at what can we get from packaging them together and growing revenues based on our existing content as opposed to continually to develop new content. So an integrated portfolio would include, you know, things like books, journals, news, conference proceedings, guidelines, educational models, patient literature, and multimedia. And what the American Psychiatric Publishing Institute did recently is bring it all together in Psychiatry Online. So what we've got here is an integrated library that has the DSM, their primary reference database, a collection of books, journals, guidelines, CME self-assessments, news, patient information, et cetera. These are all things that they have been publishing separately for years, and they brought them all together under a semantically enriched interface. And it's also, it's not apparent here, but it's also acknowledging what a user has access to. So if you have purchased access to multiple products across the platform, those will appear for you dynamically. But at the same time, the individual products can stand on their own because they're going to have different lives with the users. So therefore, even within this interface, a journal looks like a journal, a textbook looks like a textbook, news has its own skin, and then the bookstore as well. The next area that I want to focus on is kind of the back end and what we've learned from publishers and how they're going to manage the process of getting their content published online. And there's been a great demand for automated content loading, but also tagging tools to enable them to control themselves what gets tagged and how. So here's just a snapshot of the back end of our Tagmaster tool. Where you can see publishers uploaded articles for an issue, and they then go into through the automated tagging process, and the publisher, depending on their level of interest, can go in and delete tags, adjust tags, start to see how the article semantic fingerprint is coming together, and then make any tweaks that they need to. And these will all drive the topic collections and the associations that they want to make between across their content within their website. And the next aspect that we've heard about quite a bit is focusing once again on UI design and really making sure that the interface design is integrated with the architecture and the underlying structure of the product, because the UI is only going to be successful unless it's is conducted with a solid understanding of the architecture, and the product will only be successful with a good interface. So what we see here, it's a couple of UI decisions based on the same underlying technology. So this is a topic collection on Psychiatry Online. And what we're pulling are journal articles, you know, the same things that we've seen before from across the platform. And it's in a very linear layout, too, and with the colors to signify how to navigate the thing. Whereas when you go into a similar topic collection in JBJS, which is much more graphical, they've chosen a different interface that's really going to promote the consumption of the content in a different way that's more appropriate to the users. And finally, back to what we're hearing in terms of product development and strategy is that publishers are leaning towards a more evidence-based product development plan. And so pre-launch, what we're seeing is there is a trend towards analyzing and evaluating what they already have and taking a close look at what works and what doesn't, and making some decisions in order to get their sites up and running as quickly as possible. But then very quickly moving into post-launch product development, which is based on analytics. There's been a lot of focus on using not only basic reporting, but other external analytics tools to really understand what's happening on their sites, what's being used, how are users responding to what they have, and then really using those as tools to make changes, do experiments, and innovate in the long run. So, thank you very much. Cool.